Stood up, but I didn't want room to move, but this is kind of bad, I guess.
Perfect.
Yeah, not for me.
Sehr komisch.
was like, I don't want to pull one, so I love the deep.
Thank you. I Yeah. We'll do again. One of my favorite movies was some guy just fighting the Aikido dude.
Oh, yeah. Where he kicks him in the leg.
Yeah.
And he's like,
yeah, exactly. He's
a long hair dude. Yeah. Versus the bald sleeveless man. Yeah, and he had said like a little rant that he had on social media where he was just like, Aikido is better. As soon as he gets kicked in the leg.
He's like, open palm
style. Yeah.
So hard, too.
I think I hit him hard.
Yeah,
yeah, that
was fucking painful.
I'd be like,
time
out,
dude.
Yeah.
That guy was like, I'm jacked.
You'll see.
It's a 30-minute match.
That being said, I think it would be fun to do with Peter.
Yeah, I did it for like 2 years.
You did?
In high school.
Did you learn anything cool?
Oh. Come on, I mean, it's like
if three of us can't.
The cool thing about it is still very traditional. Like, you know, like that aspect. Like, it's kind of cool. Like, they feel like you'll learn everything by name and, you know, you do like history and stuff. It was hard to tell because I was in high school. I mean, I wrestled like the bigger guys. They would always like, I'd ask them if they want to wrestle after class, and they would. But most of them were like fat older guys.
Yeah.
They would just get wrecked.
I mean, like, I don't think that it is...
The place is closed now, by the way.
I don't think in any way it is a valid martial art in and of itself. Like what I mean is, like, do I think that, like, if you only train Aikido, you would really have, like, strong self-defense skills?
And it's I think it needs, like, an exact situation.
Yeah. And I think that...
I think the
idea of it is master-level grappling, and you're starting out with the most difficult thing in the world. Like, for example, like, it's easy to teach someone to grab someone around the body or grab a leg and pick it up and off-balance the other person. Like, that's a lot easier to acquire than, like, perfectly grabbing a hand out of the air and twisting it in a way to take the person down. Like... you would think, like, if you had done martial arts and grappling, like, you know, for fucking 50 years or something, you know, like, you would maybe eventually get to this point where you can just twist people's hands and make them fall over. But, like, in the beginning, you're going to need to grab something a lot bigger, like a leg or a body or something, like, easier to attain. That's why I think it doesn't work. It's like you're asking for something unrealistic. Like, it's like, yo, like, just pick, if we just tell people to fucking grab both legs and run through the person, like, they're going to have a lot more success knocking people over than this other group where we're going to ask to perfectly snatch someone's hand out of the air and twist it at the exact angle where they're going to fall and not get hit, you know? But I do think, like, if you have been doing jiu-jitsu for, like, a really long time, you have the ability to, like, suss out what's bullshit and what could be real, that, like, you might be able to fucking, like, be like, oh, okay, this actually is pretty cool, like, maybe I can do this. Like, I fucking got a wrist lock that I learned from watching Under Siege 2, Steven Seagal, and I thought it was the coolest thing in the world to learn that I could rewind it in VHS tape and, like, watch it over and over again.
All
right, got it. And then, like, of course, it would never work. Then later, doing jiu-jitsu, when I was in 50-50 with people, they'd grab my wrist and I'd do it. I'd hit people with it, and I'm like, Under Siege 2, bitch. And if you're curious about that technique, here it is. We'll be at 50-50, and your right hand grabs my right wrist.
Understand.
That's it. You're here, you pin their hand, and you go out, and you like, attack the joint.
You literally held your elbow.
I've fought people in that shit, and then, you know, not in the tournament, but like, they'll either definitely like rip their hand away, they're like, oh shit, and like let go. But you know, if you're trying to dig out the heel hook and they're trying to like grab your wrist and pull it off, you're like, Under Siege 2.
It's probably required that you say it.
You have to. You have to.
Yeah,
or else it doesn't work. You have to, yeah, it's like writing a paper and not having a bibliography.
It's like our plagiarism.
Yeah.
They're
asking you, like, I think I think obviously it works just the timing. It's like you're expecting people to time intercepting a strike
in
their life, which is, once you like really think about it, it's too hard.
Yeah, it's too hard. You're asking for master level fucking shit, and you're dealing with beginners. Like, for example, like an armbar, I can control an armbar because I have my whole body holding it. You know what I mean? So, like, when I control that arm, like, it's not going anywhere. I'm using my legs and everything. Like, they be doing armbars like this, where it's like, you know? Like, for me to be able to, like, control you with this, I have to be perfect. It's like, yeah, I can put pressure on your joint, but then you just rotate a little bit, and if you're sweaty, like, I'm going to lose it. But, like, yeah, it does work. You know, if you fucking get it and you just start with it, you can like, oh, I can do a little bit of this. But if they start really like thrashing, it's fucking impossible to hold on to. That's where it's like, so that would be like master level armbar control. Like I can put my pressure on you perfectly and just steer you around. But it's like, if we're not masters, yeah, maybe we should just like use our whole
body. One more, go ahead. You have an arm.
I think it's, like I said, I don't think it's like a real martial art, but I think like,
yeah.
For all these people that have been in risk for fucking millennia, like, they've been doing a lot of research and something silly, like, I'm sure something's cool in that, like, that they've discovered, but.
I gotta rewatch Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon and see what I can find.
Bro,
that's what
I tell you what,
fuck yeah.
Like, running up walls, dude.
That's sick.
Running up walls, jumping from tree limb to tree limb.
That's pretty cool.
That's effective.
I think I could work that out somehow.
Those dudes were parkour masters.
100%. I still say, if I'm fighting anybody, I'm taking all my clothes off and running.
I mean, that's great.
My blade
I'm getting all the way naked. If they still want to fight me, they deserve it.
Show me.
No. I
thought
you were going to say,
what's that?
I'm going to say, you grab my wrist. Here.
Show me.
Try to control your hand. So, if it's my right to your right, and then you pin my hand to your wrist, and now you draw a circle with this one. Yep. Your outfit's in my hand. Yeah, you just need to make sure I can't get
that guy who I World's last year, the one guy, he did
it.
Oh, did he?
I love this.
The big guy.
Yeah, yeah. I think that's why he thought he could do the knuckle thing.
Yeah.
This one I find is working and you get like all the fingers and shit. But,
yeah.
Maybe this makes more sense.
Yeah. So like when you do the under siege one, you want to think about like almost like the blade of your wrist hitting this. So like you don't want to just grab it, you want to like aim that in, you see what I mean? And then you can crush it.
That's Maybe that's the next step.
That's good tip. That's good tip.
Working out this I'm ready. I learned that as a kid. It was like my only martial arts move. I was like, man, motherfucker grabs me right hand or right wrist.
We're ready to But you people come out of woodwork.
But dude, I wanna maybe once a week just fuck around.
I don't know where they do it anymore.
Only wrist locks, it's like slappers only, oh gold now, you can only submit with wrist locks.
Yeah, there's still wrist locks. There's a spot on Main Street that does it. And then my old coach didn't run that. He goes to the and he goes somewhere else. I forget where he goes, but he pays the guy for private lessons to learn. But he just wants to. He does the same thing. He just wants to fuck around and see if there's anything cool.
It's hard to imagine. Like, that
I
still
I think Virginia
has like one. You know, they always do not wrestle with the class, something like that.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Like,
so fucking.
When you go to
the you should have perfect ones that you know.
Yeah,
like,
unusually hot for where it is.
It's great for like mountain biking.
This feels like I can do this to you no matter what
your numbers are.
Yeah, almost like if you were to fight the instructor, you would still do the same thing. Yeah, if I go fucking to a theater class, like, I wouldn't even. I just know I'm gonna be all beat everybody up. And yeah. I'm sound like a douche, but like, I mean, it's a hero. But like, yeah. I'm just hoping I can also, like, not make the other instructor feel weird.
Yeah, yeah,
like,
this
jiu-jitsu guy can fucking kick my ass. But no, I just wanna learn their thing. Like, that's it.
I'm here to be respectful. This is the everlasting round.
Something like that. He's like,
did you see the 10-minute mark?
Sure. But like, I can do one to you too, and I'm gonna just take your hands and I'm just gonna slap you in.
Yeah. I had a guy who powers today, but he's over at Tri-City.
Leave this place and see if
we're in Colonial Heights.
Learn from our mistakes.
Learn from us.
Be better than us.
2003, 2004.
Oh my God.
You are the chosen one.
Kind of like the drums I'm doing. Like the hair. And yeah, karate. Like one of those super thin like karate bees. And he's young dude. This guy fucking saves up for the rest of the world later. But anyway. He's like, yeah, man, I've been training for about a year and a half in my brother's garage. We've been doing ninjutsu.
Hell yeah.
And I was like, all right, man. Well, you know, it's going to be a little different. And so...
Lower your expectations.
So we go to roll. Yeah. I can't do anything. This has never done shit before. And I wasn't good. I was like, I'm not good at all. But I could do his ass. And I'm grounded him. And he starts reaching for my throat, and I was like, hey, what are you doing? And he's like,
shit. Going
for a throat grab. Yeah.
What?
And I was like, bro, man. It was pretty hard, so I knew the mouth.
Yeah, it was like.
I can do that action. And I just like, grab my ass. And I was like, we can do this.
We can do that.
No eyes, no throats. So then we run and he starts digging this fucking number in my rib again. And I was just like, stop doing this kind of shit. Stop trying to fucking just hurt me. Oh man, I can't eat my eggs.
You're pulling up.
And I was just like, bro, you're a fabulous human being. Why did I
never? Here?
He's trying to push me. He's a purple belt. Yeah. he lasted.
I mean, if you were a blue belt and he's just a purple belt now,
he's on that 15-year belt promotion. Yeah, he's been training for a good friend now. I mean, he's kind of, I think he's been like that on and off. He's bounced around. And he's kind of buried over Tri-City.
That's funny. I'm going to maintain that.
Doing his thing.
Oh, wow. Now, I'll you're happy with it. I'm going to show you what comes to my head. And I'm going to parallel with you, and then I'm just going to drop my head.
That going parallel makes a big difference.
I've never done that before.
This guy Justin Cork showed me that.
Uh-huh.
But it really seems to help.
Cool.
Like it's, I feel like I'm able to get my weight more like over their, mm-hmm. their elbow. Do you want it? Get that as deep as you can go. And cut the cross collar choke. And you might come up.
Instead of going here, I would go here and then squeeze. So
that sucks.
Yeah, like I would try to get my whole chest on it and then like hug you here. But you're saying like just finish that way.
Yeah, and maybe it's because I was putting it in my elbow pit instead of my chest.
I think it is really important that you get your shoulder on top.
Okay.
But then once I do that, then I'll come over and then I'll give him a big hug.
His explanation to it was when you go parallel like that, it puts a wall, so I can't turn mm-hmm. into you.
Yeah, that makes sense.
It was his explanation.
Cool. There's always a million ways to fuck each other people and do things. But it's also cool to like see like different ways to do it.
Yeah.
You just take it for granted. It's like, well, this is how you do that, but.
It could have something. This guy's like 5'2", like 20 pounds. So like maybe it's just because of his body
mm-hmm.
size. It's what he did. I don't know.
Yeah.
He was the guy that was on that Outlast show.
What's that?
He was that guy that was on the show Outlast.
Uh-huh.
He was. He does all the Costa Rica stuff too.
Oh, okay.
But that's where I met him. He was on that Outlast show. He was like, you ever see that on Netflix?
Mm-hmm.
It's like one of those survivor type shows.
Mm-hmm.
And he almost made it to the end, but he like kind of pissed everybody.